so great.
Ingo, Ingo.
Yeah.
Hey, man, it's time for 5 minutes with Ingo.
Sure, why not? So, do you remember last time that we talked about how to assess model quality and the accuracy of models?
Models help people. They make them feel good about themselves.
All right, okay. Remember last time? We've been talking about model validation. We have been talking about how to calculate how well a model is predicting the future.
Yep.
So, and I promise that we are going to talk about a very powerful concept for that, which is called cross-validation. So look at those data points here. So I've put numbers on top of them. 1 and whatever this one here is, 7, 10, 2, and so on. So we have all those data points here. And what we can do now is actually take one of those data points out. We use all the other data points for building a model. So let's, for example, start with number 1. We take it out, put this somewhere else. We actually now build a model on the rest of the data points, and then we apply this model on this one data point we've been taking out. So have a quick look. Play with the car.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. So this model is actually pretty easy to find. So you could, for example, say whenever you see a cube, the color is red. So you're predicting the color of the of those building blocks here.
You can read minds.
So in this case, it's a cube, so it's red. That's correct. So you put this back in here, you take number 2. Same model would be created. It's a cube, so it's red. Correct as well. Now for the first time, we get a blue triangle here. But if you look at this data, we can use the model of red cubes here. So we would say then probably this one here is a triangle. And that's also correct. Unfortunately, you really like Chevys, do you?
Oh, sorry, yeah.
So this one here, number 4, is interesting because now you can clearly see all the cubes are red, all the triangles are blue. So the model is 100% sure it's going to be blue. But the model is wrong. It's actually red, as you can see. So that can happen. It's not like a model needs to be correct in all the time, all cases. We have like noise, we have special situations the model is not covering. You don't want to run into this risk of overfitting, so that's a normal thing.
He's absolutely right.
Thank you.
So far we have been correct 3 times. We haven't been correct 1 time. And just believe me that for all the other cases we will be correct as well.
So okay.
That means we are correct in 90% of all the cases. And that's how you can come up with the validation performance or the model performance by using a cross-validation. So, but the big problem here is, as you can see, we have like 10 data points. So if you would do this like that, you would also build 10 models, which is okay for small data sets. But if you have 10 billion data points, you can't do this. So another idea would be this one here. So instead of doing what we just did by looking at one data point after the other, you can also put the data into batches. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So right now I have like 25 data points here. I have 5 batches. Each batch consists of 5 data points. And for each batch I can now calculate how often am I correct. So we have the same data points here. And for example, for this batch, I'm correct. I think it's in 80% of the cases.
Yep.
Here, is it 60?
It's 60.
Cool. And here?
80.
180. Right?
180.
So now we can just build the average of those correctnesses. That's not even an English word.
That's definitely Jinglish, but go on.
That's what I thought. Anyway, so it would be 80%. So now we are doing this on a much larger data set, but we don't build like, whatever, 25 models, but only 5 models. So we built 5 different models, and we never built a model on the same data as the test set here we are applying the model on. So we always take one out here, build the model here, apply the model there, and by that we are also assuring that you're not running into this risk of overfitting. So I think you had a question.
If you have 5 data batches, does that mean you have to train 5 different models?
You serious? I just told you that a moment ago.
That's exactly what it means.
Okay. All right. Oh, and I have a follow-up question.
Cool.
Okay, so which one is the best?
So that's actually the most frequent question we are getting from RapidMiner users as well. So because you build five different models and they have different accuracies, so you could think this one here is the best because it's correct most often. But what you're doing there, if you would just take this model built on those data points, those 20, you would actually do some overfitting on this particular test data set. And that's also not a good idea. So in general, we would like to train as a model on as much data as possible. So instead of taking one of those five, you just build a complete new model on all 25 data points, and that's your final model. So what this really is doing is just estimation of the accuracy, but it's not really creating one single model. You build the model on the complete data. And that's it for today.
And this has been your 5 minutes with Ingo.
Interesting.